Tsunami Gupta again with the new topic of your SSC, that is our soil. It is very important topic. You have got to read only in your junior classes. Several questions is from your, in your higher classes also. So first of all, you understand what is soil. You should know that soil is the combination of, now you can say, components of rocks, pieces of gravels, mud, it is. So if you are talking about soil, soil is very important part of our life. It is important for all the living things or non-living things also. If you are talking about soil, life is impossible, because if there would be no soil, there will be no plants. If there is no plants, there will be no human beings. There will be no human beings. Means you can understand the connection of all the living things and non-living things. The soil is very important. If you are talking, soil is different in different places. It may be of because of different physical features and climate. If the place of desert we are talking, the soil of desert would be different if we are comparing with the mountain. So you can imagine that the types of soil depends upon the what type of physical feature and climate is of that place. So if you are talking, you should know it takes 100 to 1000 years to make 1 centimeter of soil. Understand that 100 to 1000 years to make 1 centimeter of soil. So this soil takes too much time to be made, and it is very important part of life. And not only that, if the soil is not present, the plants cannot survive. And so we are going to read in this chapter some of the soil. And soil, if you are talking, there are 6 type of soil. So we will go one by one. So the first soil, if you are talking, it is alluvial soil. Second is the mountain soil. Third is the black soil. Fourth is the red soil. Then it comes desert soil and laterite soil. So we will go one by one to all this soil. You have to know what are this type of soil. It is good for which type of crops. What type of crops can be grown in such soil. So if you are talking about the first, you know alluvial soil. The word alluvial soil, because let me explain that it is, you can say, it has too much alluvium, and this alluvium, it makes the soil too much fertile. You know that soils which comes from Himalaya range is makes too much land fertile. life, you can say that is rice, wheat, sugarcane, pulses, jute and vegetable. So this type of crops are grown in alluvial soil. So you can make the chart and remember what type of crops are found in alluvial soil. So the answer is the rice, wheat, sugarcane, pulses. Pulses you are going, which is good source of protein you are eating also. Jute and vegetables obviously. Again, if you are talking the this type of soil in found in which part of our country, then alluvial soil, as it is very fertile soil, it is found in the part of Punjab, Haryana, Uttar Pradesh, part of Bihar, Madhya Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, Assam and eastern coastal plain. This type of soil is also found in coastal areas also, that is the eastern side. So you have understood what is alluvial soil, and this is found in the Deccan plateaus also. Plateaus, I have explained that Deccan plateau. First of all, you are knowing what is plateau. This is the high elevated land is called as plateau. So this is alluvial soil. So first soil which we have read is known as alluvial soil. The second soil we are going to study is the black soil. Understand that this soil is, by the name itself you can just understand, it is black soil. It is black in color. Why black? Because it is formed by the lava. Lava, you are knowing that when the volcano erupts, lava comes out. So this hot molten magma, when it makes the volcano erupts, so lava comes out, and this type of soil, black soil, is formed by the lava. And this black soil is very good for the cultivation of cotton and sugarcane. You are knowing that cotton is very much useful for the textile industry and sugarcane for the sugar mill industry. So this is also the important crops which are cultivated here in the black soil. The third type of soil, if you are talking, it is the red soil. So where this type of soil is found? It is found in the rest part of the Deccan plateau. I have mentioned that the black soil is found in the northwestern part of Deccan plateau, and the rest part of Deccan plateau, red soil is found. Why it is red soil called? It is called as red soil because iron content is there. Just you are knowing, if there is iron present, the thing will change into red in color. You can see the rusting happening in the utensil. In which color it changes into red. So we can say that this soil is found in the rest part of Deccan plateau, and it is formed by the weathering of metamorphic rock also. You have read about three types of rocks: igneous rocks, sedimentary rocks, metamorphic rocks. So this is formed by the breaking down of crystallized form of metamorphic rock. And the crops here found are jowar, bajra, pulses and groundnuts. You are knowing that groundnuts, the children like to eat. So, which type of cultivation of crops can be grown in red soil? It is jowar, bajra, groundnuts, pulses. So, if we are talking about next type of soil, it is the mountain soil. You are knowing this soil is found in mountain area and it is coarse. I told the soil of every places are not same. It is different in different area depending upon the physical features and climate. So you are knowing that mountain is a hilly area. So the soil found here is very coarse. And in this type of soil, especially the vegetables are, you can see the orchard of fruits and vegetables. So mountain soil is good for fruit and vegetables also. So you can see in some part of hilly area, you can see the orchards of apples or other fruits also. Next is, if you are talking that desert soil, as the word desert, you are knowing the area which does not receive the heavy rainfall. So we can just take the part of Rajasthan which has the desert soil, and this soil is sandy. Means you are knowing that the sands is, the soil here is full of sand. So you have remembered that I have taught the sand dunes are formed in the desert area. And the crops grown here are wheat, gram and dates. Again, dates is very good for health, and these are imported and exported from the desert area. So the crops grown in the desert soils are wheat, gram and dates. The last type of soil, if I am speaking, then it is laterite soil. Where does it develop? It develops in area where it has high temperature and heavy rainfall. And because of heavy rainfall, there is leaching in the soil. Means leaching means there is no humus. And this result, this type of soil is made suitable for the crops by adding fertilizers and manures. This is not good for the crops, so the fertilizers is added, manures is added in laterite soil. And so the types of crops grown in laterite soil is tea, coffee, rubber and coconut. So this type of soil, if we are talking laterite soil, it is filled with, because of heavy rainfall, it has leaching in this type of soil. Humus is very less, and due to that, the crops which are grown here is cultivated by adding fertilizers and manures. So the crops grown in laterite types of soil are tea, coffee, rubber and coconut. So you understand the sixth type of soil, that is alluvial soil, mountain soil, black soil, red soil, desert soil and laterite soil. So abandoned, which also result in the soil erosion. So to stop the soil erosion to some of the extent, we can plant more and more trees, and embankment also can be made so that the soil can be hold it in one place, and this will help for the cultivation of too many crops. And if the agriculture of a place is very much developed, the place will also be developed. You are knowing that if the country has to develop, the agriculture is prospering, then that place also develops. So we have read about soil. So question again, if you are talking about this chapter, can come. What is, or you can say, yes, what is soil? So soil is the combination of rocks, particles, gravel. You can just add that soil takes 100 to 1000 years to make 1 centimeter of soil. Next, second question is that write the type of soil. If you are thinking, the third question is several type asked. Which type of soil is good for cultivation of cotton? So what will be the answer? For the cotton and sugar cane, especially if you are talking about cotton, the soil which is very good is black soil. And you can just give about black soil, how it is formed. It is formed from the lava. Again, question is that explain the laterite soil. Or if the question comes in this way, why in the laterite soil the fertilizers and manures are added? So I have explained that laterite soil, manures and fertilizers are added to make it of good quality so that the crops can be cultivated. So in this chapter we read about the soil, and we are coming with the next topic in the next class. So thank you everyone, keep learning.